Hi guys, welcome to Miraketa Tribe. My name is Ayushi. This is going to be a general reading for anybody who is watching it. So this is a random general reading, and whenever you are watching this, it should apply. Let's see what's coming up. Just two more cards and then we will start the reading. So the first card that we have here is the Three of Pentacles. So I feel that some of you here are trying to create something, and while you are trying to create whatever that you are trying to create, which can be very painful, because I feel that you are also simultaneously trying to heal yourself. So some of you are trying to work something out as well as try to heal somebody, or try to heal yourself, are trying to heal yourself. But I feel that you are not able to process your emotions really well. I see that some of you are trying to make some money here while you are emotionally not feeling so well or not feeling inspired. You could be dealing with an Aquarius Sun Moon Rising. However, there is an opportunity that you know there is something that you can make on, like something that you can build upon. You know there is something in your hand that you can build upon, and you can start, like grab this resource or idea and make it something tangible. But in past, you feel that somebody tricked you. Like you feel that somebody gave you something but took it back, or they gave you some taste of something but they like as if somebody offered you something and then took it back from you. That's what I'm getting here. Even though you were very cautious, with entire thing, like investing your time in this, but you did not see it coming, that somebody actually tricked you. Now on your mind, you are grieving about something that has already happened. So you are grieving about this, and it's like somebody said something to you which is still echoing in your ears, and you are not able to forget it, whatever they have said. So it's bothering you, whatever they have said, it's bothering you, and it's replaying in your head over and over again. In future, things are going to change. If you are in a bad place right now, things will change. That's what I'm getting, because it's Wheel of Fortune in future. So you might not see something miraculous is going to happen, which you are not expecting. And something from the past is going to come back is what I'm getting. Usually I don't get that kind of message with this card, but I'm getting that somebody from the past will come. But again, be very mindful. This person can play a this person can cast a spell on you, or a similar situation that happened in the past can play out again. So be mindful of that. how you come up in this reading is as Three of Wands. So yes, you are waiting for somebody or someone to come your way or something to come your way. Like you have invested a lot in something and now you are waiting very patiently for this thing to grow or whatever it is that you are trying to wait on. You're very patiently waiting for something to come your way. But in your surrounding, something has ended, like completely finished. So somebody around you is going through a cycle where they are completing a cycle, like they are either ending a situation with somebody that they were already dealing with, or like a divorce, or they are going through a breakup. So somebody around you is ending something, either with you or in their own life, or something at their workplace, or generally things are changing around you because an era is coming to an end, basically. Ten of Cups is coming up as your hopes and fears. So you want some beautiful family, or you want some relationship, or you want to spend time with your family. That's your hopes. That is in your hopes and desires. Your outcome is that you will get Nine of Cups. Here you are wishing for Ten of Cups, but you will get Nine of Cups, which is again emotional fulfillment, your wishes coming true. But the problem here is that you really don't know what you actually want. Like, you are conflicted in the fact that even though you feel that you want something, it's not actually what you need. And somehow you know that, like you are wishing for something, but you know that it's bad for you. You are wishing for something, but you know that it's toxic for you, is what I'm getting here. So you have to make that clear decision if you really want something. So be mindful of what you are wishing for. Probably you are asking for someone to come back to whom that you are addicted, and that person has already cheated or has been lying to you. Or has been very deceptive in past. You could be dealing with a Aries, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, or let me see here, Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, and Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising. Any water sign is also an earth sign, basically. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. So these are the energies that I'm getting. Now, bottom of the deck here is Seven of Pentacles. So Seven of Pentacles here is telling me, let me check, this is not seven, this is Six of Pentacles. So this is telling me that be mindful of where you are giving your energy. Are you giving your energy to somebody who is in a three party, or this person is again going to come back and break your heart, or has already broken your heart? So are you really waiting for this person? Like, are you begging to, for this person to come back, who has not treated you properly, or who has not invested as much as you have invested in them? I'm also getting that something has already crumbled, something like a change has happened, something shifted in your life entirely. And you had to go through a Ten of Swords situation. So this is betrayal, and this is entire shifting in your life. And then you already had a World card here. Something had already ended here. And then Three of Swords. So definitely some sort of a betrayal, some sort of cycles that are ending here. And Nine of Wands is telling me that you are exhausted. You don't want to go through this over and over again. You are already crying over something that you have already lost in past. So you are already sad about it. Simultaneously, you are trying to work upon something that you know will build your financial stability, because you know that you have a job offer or some opportunity that you can grab right now. Or you have already invested in something and you are waiting for its returns. Like, you are waiting for some growth to happen, something to come your way. But what's stopping you is that you are not feeling inspired, and you feel that you need a lot of healing. So either you are needing a lot of healing, or somebody around you is needing a lot of healing and support. So that was the random reading. I will see you guys again. Take care.